Hi! Did you know that you can create actionable notifications in Home Assistant? This way you can get a message on your phone and choose some actions within that message. Home Assistant will perform your chosen action after you've chosen a specific action. In this video, I'll show you how you will get a message on your phone when your printer ink cartridges are almost empty and what actions you can perform within that message. Let's go! Actionable notifications are messages that you receive on your phone and that present a couple of actions that you can perform within that message. We will create the following use case in this tutorial. When your printer ink cartridges are almost empty, you will get a message on your phone. Within that message, you get three options: order new cartridges, remind me later, and ignore. For this, we will use the actionable notifications functionality of Home Assistant. You can also check the documentation online if you like to know more about this. The link is in the description below. After you've created the script automations and helper for this use case, it will look like this on your phone. Actionable notifications always work together with automations that handle the actions within the notification. So, if you choose a certain action within a notification, an automation will trigger based on that event and perform the action that you've chosen. For this use case, we are going to create a script, a helper, and three automations. This use case is one example that shows how you can use actionable notifications. You can alter this example to your needs for different cases, of course. We start with creating a script. The script sends the actionable notification to your phone. You might wonder why I use a script for this. Well, this is because I want to be able to let Home Assistant remind me using a notification again when I click Remind in the actionable notification. So, I can call the script multiple times instead of having to create multiple automations with the same code. You can create a script by going to Settings, Automations and Scenes, then go to the Scripts tab and click on Add Script. The script looks like this. The name is Notify Printer Cartridge is Almost Empty. Within Sequence, I've added a Call Service action, and the service in my case is Notifications, Send a Notification via Mobile App iPhone X at. The message is Your printer cartridges are almost empty. The title is Printer Alert. The actionable part is filled in the data field. What you see here are the actions that will be shown below the message on your phone. For each action, you can add some parameters. Not all parameters work the same for Android and iPhone. iPhone has some more parameters that you can use. See the documentation of actionable notifications for this. The link is in the description below. We start with actions. Each action has an identifier. In our case, these identifiers are order URI, remind, and ignore. We will use these three action IDs later as identifiers in automations. The action order URI leads us to the URL where I can buy new cartridges for my printer. The title is the action message that is shown on my phone. In this case, order new cartridges now. The icon shows an icon next to the action message. This is only supported on iPhones at this moment. You cannot use MDI icons like you normally would use in Home Assistant. The icons that you can use here can be found on sfsymbols.com. And the URI contains the URL where I can buy my cartridge. So, when I click on Order New Cartridges Now, I will be led to the URL where I can order the cartridges. The action Remind makes sure that I get a reminder later to order the cartridges. This action also has a title and an icon. So, when I click Remind Me Later, I will get a reminder every day at 12 PM that my ink cartridges are almost empty. This is handled by an automation that I will show later in this tutorial. The last action is called Ignore and just ignores the message. This action also has a title and an icon. I also added the option Destructive True. Because of this option, the message will be shown in red on iPhones. So, when I click Ignore, the message will be ignored and it will make sure that I won't get reminders anymore. You can test the script by clicking on Run Script. The script will just show the message and the options that you can choose, but no actions will be performed yet. To make sure that the reminder action works, we are going to need to create a helper. This helper will store if we want to get a reminder or not. For this, we use the Boolean or toggle helper. You can create a helper by going to Settings, Devices and Services, then go to the Helpers tab and click Create Helper. Select the type toggle. Give the helper the name, printer, ink, reminder, and click Create. Now we are going to create three automations. The first automation checks if the cartridges of our printer are below a certain value. If this is the case, then it will call the script that we've just created. You can create an automation by going to Settings, Automations and Scenes, then go to the Automations tab and click on Create Automation. After that, click on Start with an empty automation. Our automation looks like this. The automation has the name Notify Printer Ink is Low. I've created two triggers, one for the black and white cartridge and one for the color cartridge. The first trigger is of type device and the trigger is Canon MX 510 series black value changes. At below, I've set the value to 20. So I want to get a message if the cartridge percentage dropped below 20%. I did the same for the color cartridge. Then at actions, I will just call the script that we've just created. You can do that by selecting the action type call service and selecting our created script in the drop-down list that is shown after that. So if the black or color ink cartridge is below 20%, this automation triggers the script and we will get an actionable notification on our phone. However, the actions still do not work. In this next automation, we will bring the actions to life. Create a new automation by going to Settings, Automations and Scenes, then go to the Automations tab and click on Create Automation. After that, click on Start with an empty automation. This new automation looks like this. The name of the automation is Notify Handle Printer Ink Notification Actions. We are creating three event triggers in this automation. One that triggers when the reminder event is fired, one that triggers if the cartridge ordered event is fired, and one that triggers when the ignore event is fired. The first trigger is of type event and the event type is Mobile App Notification Action. We add the action that we defined in our script within the field event data. In this case, that is action remind. We give this trigger the trigger ID setReminder. I've created a tutorial about trigger IDs. They are very powerful, so check that tutorial out if you do not know how trigger IDs work. So this trigger triggers based on the action remind of the mobile app notification action event. We will create an action later that turns our printer ink reminder helper on. The second trigger is also of type event and the event type is again mobile app notification action. In this case, the action is order URI. We give this trigger the trigger ID cartridge ordered. So this trigger triggers based on the action order URI of the mobile app notification action event. We will create an action later that turns our printer ink reminder helper off. We do not really need any reminder notifications anymore after we ordered new cartridges, right? The third trigger is also of type event, and the event type is again mobile app notification action. In this case, the action is ignore. We give this trigger the trigger ID ignore. This trigger will also turn the printer ink reminder helper off. If my videos help you and if you want to stay up to date with my tutorials and not miss anything to increase your knowledge of Home Assistant and Smart Home, subscribe to my channel and tick the bell. It also helps if you post a comment. This way more people get notified about these videos. I need your support so that I can keep creating these videos for you. Oh, and don't forget to hit the thumbs up for this video. This allows me to make more tutorials for you. By supporting me, you also support my work as a music therapist to help people with mental issues. Thank you. Now, let's set up the actions for this automation. We start with the choose action because we have three different triggers. Within the choose action, we create three options. The condition within option 1 is triggered by, and the trigger ID is setReminder. The action within this option is of type call service, and the service is input boolean turnOn. The entity that we want to turn on is our printer ink reminder helper. The condition within option 2 is also triggered by, and the trigger ID is cartridge ordered. The action within this option is of type call service, and the service is input boolean turn off. The entity that we want to turn off is our printer ink reminder helper. The same counts for option 3. The condition within option 3 is also triggered by, and the trigger ID is ignore. The action within this option is of type call service, and the service is also input boolean turn off. The entity that we want to turn off is again our printer ink reminder helper. So basically, this automation turns the printer ink reminder helper on and off. Now we only have to create one more automation that acts upon the status of the printer ink reminder helper. This might sound like magic to you, and I can totally understand that. Home Assistant uses events to trigger actions. So Home Assistant listens for events, and as soon as an event is triggered, it will perform actions. You can check this yourself by going into the developer tools and going to events. On the right side of the screen, you see a list of active listeners. You can fill the listen to events field with one of these listeners and see what it returns. In our case, that is mobile app notification action. If you click on start listening after that and run the script and select an action in your notification, you will see that it shows the action. These actions can be intercepted by automations, which is exactly what we are doing here. Now, let's create our last automation to get everything to work. Create a new automation by going to Settings, Automations and Scenes, then go to the Automations tab and click on Create Automation. After that, click on Start with an empty automation. Our automation is named Notify Remind Printer Cartridges Almost Empty. I added a trigger that is of type time, and in this example, it will trigger daily at 12 p.m. Now we only want this automation to trigger when our printer ink reminder helper is turned on. So we add a condition to check the value of that helper. At condition, I added a state condition. The entity is the printer ink reminder helper, and the state that we want to check is on. So with this condition, the automation will only trigger if the printer ink reminder helper state is on. At action, we add a call service action and select the script that we created before. So this automation sends us a reminder to our phone every day at 12 p.m. You can download all the code that I created in this video via the download link in the description below. Downloading is free, but you can also choose to make a donation just before you download the code. Please consider sponsoring me if my work saves you time. This way, you support me so that I can keep making these videos for you. And with this, our use case is finished. Let me know in the comments if you managed to get it to work. Do you have other use cases for Actionable notifications? Let me know too in the comments. I hope this video helped you, and I want to thank everyone who has supported me in making these videos and tutorials so far. I could never have done this without you. Thank you. You can support me through Patreon, Ko-fi, or by joining my channel. If you also want to support me, look in the description of this video for the links. With that, you make it possible that I can continue to make these videos for you. Oh, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and hit the notification bell. I will see you soon. Bye bye.